So today we will discuss about protection of solar PV system. Okay, last four session we discussed if it is visible. Okay, if it is not visible also no problem. In the next slide I will show it. So like that number of arrays can be connected. Right. So here each string should be protected, and the protecting device. And so first this is the string, so each and every string should be protected. So you can see each string connected with fuse, okay. And each string has the diode. So these diodes are the what bypasses the current. If there is any problem in this, have fuse. So across the positive conductor we have connected fuse, and across the negative also we have conducted the fuse. And all these strings are commonly connected at bus bars. You can see here, these are the bus bars. All the DC disconnect. This is DC disconnect. You can isolate this particular string. It is like a switch. You can on and off. You can isolate this string. So this box commonly called as the string combiner box. Like that, each and every string consisting of string combiner. Is like that, number of arrays are connected, and is it fine? So if you are not getting any audio and video, please join the click on the link again. Okay. Right. I hope it is fine. Right, I will continue. Shall I continue? Is it okay? Right. So each and every string has the string combiner box. Okay. This is said to be array, and like that number of arrays are connected. So it is said to see here clearly. Okay. This is string. Okay. Each string should be protected, and all these arrays should be connected commonly at subarray common box. So array should also be protected. So to protect the each string, we are connecting a fuse at positive conductor and negative conductor, and all these strings are commonly connected at this bus bars, positive and negative, and this then it is connected as this one. So and all these arrays are commonly connected here. So then here also each conductor has the link to protect. Next, these terminals, these array terminals are connected to the array fuse links, then it is connected to the inverter. So here inverter is plays a major role. Inverter should also be protected. Okay, here then solar PV system. So it needs string protection, array protection, and inverter protection, and all these devices can be used. So these are the fuse links, and this is the fuse holder, and this is surge protecting device. Right, first we will discuss about the string protection. So we know string. So what is string? Number of modules are connected in series. So here this is string, and each string has the positive and negative terminal, and fuse is connected, one positive terminal and negative terminal that is connected to DC disconnect. So this DC disconnect is isolates your string. The particular string can be isolated by using this DC connect. Here, when two or more strings are connected, then only fuse link is connected across the string. Otherwise, it is not required. Why? Because when less than three strings are connected, then it is does not produce enough current to damage. So when three or more strings are connected, like here you can see here how many strings are connected. One. How to select the fuse links for string protection? So here NP names number of parallel strings. See, this is one string, and this is another string, this is another, and this is another. So here these are the number of parallel strings. Here how many parallel strings are there? Four parallel strings are there. So NP is the number of parallel strings. When NP is greater than or equal to 3, that means important when consider protection, that is regarding to voltage and regarding to current. And regarding to voltage, the factor is 1.2, and regarding to current, the factor is 1.56. So generally the solar module specifications are given. That means open circuit voltage is given, short circuit current is given, and maximum power point, voltage, current, power, all these are given. For example, if equal to 3, then voltage rating must be greater than or equal to 1.2 times of open circuit voltage into NS. NS means number of series connected modules. When the number of series modules are connected in series, then voltage will be added. And that voltage should multiply with the factor 1.2. Short circuit current. So when series connected, then there will be no change, same current will be flows. When these modules are connected in parallel, then the current will be added. So the current rating should be taken like one, it should be greater than 1.56 into short circuit current. And remember, the current rating should be less than or equal to module maximum current applied with overcurrent protection range, like 15 ampere, like 20 ampere, like that. So when you are calculating the current rating, that should be less than the rating specified by the manufacturer. So this is specified by the rated at 1.56 times of IEC, then there is no fuse link connected across. It is not mandatory. That is your wish. It is not mandatory connected fuse across the each string. But remember, the number of parallel string should be less than 3, and the cable should be rated at 1.56 times of IEC. In this case, there will be no need of fuse. But if number of parallel strings are less than 3 and cable is not rated, then you have to choose the fuse link rating and voltage rating. Then fuse 1.20 into open circuit voltage into number of series connected cells. So these are the protection cases, different cases you have to remember. So we'll have one example. I will explain for this example how to choose the current rating and voltage rating of the fuse link. For example, these are the module specifications. So So here cell type is polycrystalline 0.1, short circuit current is 5.37 ampere. Maximum fuse rating is 15 ampere. And here, these are the PV installation setup. That means this is individual module specification like that. Here, 18 panels are connected in series. So NS equal to 18. And here the temperature is given, module temperature is given 60 degrees highest and lowest is minus 30, and the fuse link maximum temperature is 45 degrees centigrade. Four strings are connected in parallel. Each string has the 18 panels, and conductor size is 2.5 mm square. So for this example, we can choose the fuse rating as mentioned above here. What is the case we will get here? Number of strings are 4. So this is comes under first case. So you have to choose the voltage rating. You have to choose the to ISC, and this value should be less than or equal to over current protection range of current. This is specified by the IEC that will be indicated on the module. So this one, maximum fusing current is 15 ampere. Okay, that is nothing but this one, module maximum over current protection range. So use this formula, current rating greater than or equal to 1.56 into ISC. So here ISC is mentioned, that is 5.37. So 1.56 into 5.37, that is equal to 8.38 amperes. But mentioned conductor size is 2.5 mm square. The 2.5 mm square conductor size withstand up to 11.5 amperes VOC into NS. So open circuit voltage is given, that is 43.1. 1.20 into 43.1 into how many series panels are connected? 18. So you have to do that. So when you will get 931 volts. Now you can choose the fuse link rating. So 931 means you should choose 1000 volts DC. And you can choose the current rating more than that, is 8.38 amperes is fuse is 1000 volt DC and 10 amperes. That means this one, each fuse current rating is 10 amperes and voltage rating is 1000. I am audible. Is my voice is audible? Okay, fine. Right. Now we'll discuss array protection. So after string, what happens? So each string, sorry, array combiner box. Okay. So from DC disconnect, we'll get one positive terminal and one negative terminal. Like that, all the arrays are connected commonly. So this array combiner box. So you should have the array protection that we'll discuss now. That is this one. All the sub arrays are commonly connected at this bus bars. So here each sub array has the positive conductor and negative conductor. At each sub array you have the fuse. Module specifications we have test 4.31 and short circuit current is 5.37 ampere. Number of panels are connected 18, and this is sub arrays I have taken 3. Okay, same, how to choose the fuse rating That means current rating and voltage rating. So current rating should be greater than or equal to 1.56 into ISC, that means short circuit current, into NP. So here ISC is given, that is 5.37 ampere, and NP is 8. So you can find out, you can substitute these values and you can find out 67 ampere. Current rating should be greater than 67 ampere. And the conductor size is given 10 mm square. This conductor size of 10 mm square can withstand up to 98 amperes at the ambient temperature of 60 degree centigrade. These are the standard specifications. So you can select the standard rating more than 67, 80 amperes is available. So it is in this range. So you can select 80 amperes. So this is 80 ampere. This fuse rating is 80 ampere sub RS. So you have to include that one. Current rating should be greater than 1.56 into ISC into number of parallel into number of sub RS. Sub RS are 3. So 1.56 into 5.37 into 8 into 3 sub RS. So 201 amperes. So 201 ampere fuse is not readily available. 250 ampere is 0.1 and NS is 18. So if you multiply, you will get 931. So 931 rating is not available, above that 1000 volts is there. So here you can choose, this is 80 ampere fuse, like the 3 sub RS are connected. So 80 into 3, 240 amperes. And what is the sub RS we are getting? 250 amperes. So it is in this range. Okay, so this is 80 ampere fuse for sub array 1, and second sub array 80 ampere fuse. So this fuse gives the array protection. Okay. Next, after that array, all these arrays are connected to the inverter. So we know inverter converts DC power into the AC power. So the inverter should be protected from overload, over temperature, over voltage, under voltage, like that. Overload protection, that means here you can overload the inverter up to 25% only, maximum 25 to generate 1.25 times at the DC side. So 25% only you can overload. Okay, why? Because you will get some losses. So that 1.25 megawatt from the DC side will reaches to 1 megawatt on the AC side after considering the losses. So you have to overload the inverter. That overloading factor is up to 25% only. That means 1.25 times. If that value is exceeds, then automatically the inverter is trips. That is overload protection and over temperature protection. So this temperature, so inverter is the semiconductor device, it's semiconductor devices. So the semiconductor devices are temperature sensitive devices. When the temperature is increases, the performance increases. If it is overheated, then it will damages also. So to prevent this over temperature, we have to use the faults we have. So from ground faults also, the inverter should be protected. So for this ground power, you should use the earthing and short circuit protection. So this short circuit protection will occur on the AC side or DC side. So inverter must be protected from short circuit by using relays and circuit breakers. More than that one. For example, if it increases more than 415 volts, then insulation will be damages. So insulation damages, that damages the equipment also. Then if the system voltage is decreases beyond this 350 volts, then it draws more current. So always you have to operate the inverter in this operating voltage only. breaker, then circuit breaker will be operated. And there is one important is in inverter should have the anti-aliasing. So when the grid side is any problem, grid is failure, then the inverter should be automatically disconnected. If and one more major role of inverter is in next after the inverter, the inverter is connected to your transformer. The same way the transformer with the over voltage and under voltage, and over frequency and under frequency. If it is operated with the over frequency, then the relay will sense and it are disconnected. And if it is transformer is operated with the under frequency, if the transformer is loaded with the motor, then it draws the more current. So then also the under frequency relay will operate. And transformer should be protected from the earth fault. We have the relay operates instantaneously with no time intentional delay. Operating time is very, very low. It is in the few milliseconds, or it may be in the nanoseconds also. But in case of IDMT relay, as the current fault current is increases, then yeah, is it fine to all of you? Is I hope I'm audible. Please change the quality settings from your side. Right, I will discuss that. Then your solar. We have to use the surge protection devices. Surge protection devices are two types, external type and internal type. So in the external type, you can use the lightning rods. So here, see here on your rooftop, the lightning rod is there. When the lightning occurs, this lightning rod absorbs that lightning discharge, and it is that it provides a low impedance path, and it is discharges to the earth side. So this is the function of lightning rod. It protects from lightning strokes. And across the also surge protecting devices is connected. So you can see this is the combiner box. In the combiner box, all the equipments are commonly connected. This is the PV array, copper bus bars, and autonomous power supply. This is the surge protecting device. This is DC MCB, and these are the DC fuses. So here the surge protecting devices is there. Surge protecting device is nothing but a this like that number of solar panels are there. All the solar panels are connected through cables and this MC4 connectors. MC4 means multi contact, has the 4 mm diameter. All these are connected commonly at PV combiner box we have shown. So in the combiner box you can see surge protecting device, circuit breakers, and fuses. Then it is connected to the battery inverter to your home. So here also you have the AC side. Then here in your home also the surge protecting devices at AC side also the protecting devices, surge protecting device, circuit breaker, this will be connected. So these are the devices These are the protecting devices used and there is a necessity for a rooftop system, rooftop solar PV system. It should be protected from the lightning. So in some countries